I couldn't talk, and I would try to verbalize things, and it was just like I had no voice.
This was the second time in 2 months that Stan Lander felt this strange sensation.
I asked him a question, and he didn't answer, and so I looked at him and asked again and didn't respond.
This time, he listened to his wife, Alita, and went to his doctor, who sent him for an MRI. It revealed a mass on his brain.
We were just praying, Lord, whatever this is, we give it to you. We know that you're the healer.
The couple had no idea just how much he would need God's healing. After more testing, doctors concluded Stan had a malignant brain tumor known as primary CNS lymphoma. It was rare and, in Stan's case, inoperable.
It was a death sentence. Yeah, when he said you have, he says you have, you're looking at, you know, 3 to 6 months. I was thinking, is this really my life? This isn't the script, you know, that I've been living. This isn't the way that things are going to end. They're not going to.
There's a lot of fear that wants to grip. You can't go there. You just can't. It's like, okay, how are we going to do this? And we really said, God is our only hope. There is no other option.
That Sunday in church, the Landers asked for prayer.
You go back and you recount those testimonies where God's come through. So even in the midst of that dire prognosis, you know, there was, we knew that God was still for us and he had a plan for our life.
Later, they went for a second opinion with respected Seattle neurosurgeon known in the community as Dr. Lau. But the report was the same.
I agree with the first neurosurgeon that this most likely was tumor or cancer. And I say that from neurosurgical point of view, we cannot do anything much.
Dr. Lau is also a pastor.
So the only option left is to believe in the miracle that God can heal him.
He said, can I pray for you? I've never had a doctor pray for me before. And here Dr. Lau was praying for me. I felt the healing of his prayers that night.
By now, it had been 7 weeks since the first MRI. And as a matter of protocol, Dr. Lau ordered another. Everyone the couple knew, including Dr. Lau's church, continued praying for a miracle.
From the human point of view, it's hopeless, but we don't walk by sight, we walk by faith.
The Lord is giving you a spirit of praise for that.
Then a week before the follow-up MRI, Stan and Alita were watching the 700 Club.
And taking away that heaviness.
There's someone else. You've been diagnosed with a brain tumor. It's not a question of whether you have it or not. It's there. You question whether God can heal such a thing. Today, God is setting you free. He's totally healing that tumor. It'll just disappear.
We look at each other and go, that's for me. And it was just, it was more than icing on the cake. It was like that seal that it's a done deal.
So it was just a confirmation that, yes, you don't need to worry.
It just contributed to our hope and faith. Yeah.
Supported by prayers and hearts full of hope, Stan went for his MRI. A week later, they met with Dr. Lau for the results.
There was a sense that this is the MRI that counts. This is one that's gonna tell the story one way or another.
This is the one that when you see the picture, your jaw drop.
Dr. Lau came in and said, there's a hole in the brain where the tumor was. There's a hole in the brain.
You saw the white stuff here. It's all gone, become a cavity.
Isn't a hole in the brain still a bad thing? And he says, no, it's scar tissue. It's gone, it's completely gone.
I wanted to shout it from the rooftops and tell everybody in sight. God heals. He'd performed a miracle.
We just were laughing and crying, and it was just, it was a fabulous moment.
Ever since that day in November 2014, Stan has been the picture of health, with no signs or symptoms of brain cancer.
I have seen so many supernatural healings in my life. So that's why I believe.
It just leaves me in awe of God's goodness, of His love for us. I have learned that not to hesitate to pray for people, because God just might heal them, and there's a good possibility of it.
God is so faithful. He's just so faithful.
May the Lord bless you. I would like to pray for you and bless you. But before I pray for you, I would like to read the promises of God to build your faith and build my faith. When you have faith and you pray according to the promises of God, you shall see the miracle. I would like to read Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 12. Then say the Lord to me, you have seen well, for I mean God, alert and active, watching over my word to perform it. Our God is alert, and He's watching over His promises, and He shall perform what He promises. Numbers chapter 23, verse 19. God is not a man that He should lie, nor a son of man that He should repent. Has He said, and will He not do? Or has He spoken, and will He not make it good? The Lord promises that when He says something, He promises something, He will do according to what He said. But we need to have faith to receive from the Lord. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 20, for no matter how many promises God has made, they are yes in Christ. And so through Christ, the Amen is spoken by us to the glory of God. Wow, the promises of God in any subject of our life or any aspect of life is yes and amen. Therefore, when you listen to my prayer and receive the healing in this time, please choose faith over facts. The medical report may tell you the bad news, but you choose to have faith in the promise of God so that you can see God's best for your life. This is hope. That is to believe that the promise of God put in you will come to pass. God is working behind the scenes. What He promised you is right on schedule. Believing for God's blessing and favor, and expect God to turn things around, to perform miracles and supernatural breakthroughs. Trust Him to open the right doors for you. What God promised you does not have an expiration date. I'm going to read the promise of God concerning healing. So listen carefully and take into your heart and build your faith. God shall bless and heal those who obey Him. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verses 12 to 15. Then it shall come to pass, because you listen to these judgments and keep and do them, that the Lord your God will keep with you the covenant and the mercy which He swore to your fathers. And He will love you and bless you and multiply you. He will also bless the fruit of your womb and the fruit of your land, your grain and your new wine, and your oil, the increase of your cattle, and the offspring of your flock, in the land of which He swore to your fathers to give you. You shall be blessed above all peoples. There shall not be a male or female barren among you or among your livestock. And the Lord will take away from you all sickness and will afflict you with none of the terrible diseases of Egypt, which you have known, but will lay them on all those who hate you. God promised to heal us when we obey the Lord. And He will keep us free from every disease. That is what verse 15 say. No sickness can be upon you. Let us believe that when you believe in Jesus, do your best to obey God, He will keep you away from sickness and disease. God is our doctor or physician. Exodus chapter 15, verse 26. This is the promise of God. And said, if you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in His sight, give ear to His commandments and keep all His statutes, I will put none of the diseases on you, which I have brought on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who heals you. Our God is our healer. He's going to heal you at this time, at this moment. 2 Chronicles also mentioned about healing. 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face. I believe that you are praying right now and you are seeking God's face. That's why you turn on this program. And turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. God is the healer. Psalm 118, verse 17. I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. That is the promise of God. You will not die and live. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 1 to 2. My son, do not forget my teaching, but keep my commands in your heart, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you prosperity. This is the reason why I read all this scripture, and you take all this scripture into your heart. These scriptures are health to you, medicine to you. The Word of God will heal you today. You humble yourself before Him, and He will heal you. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 to 8. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. I believe you are trusting God right now, that God is going to heal you. And lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun evil. This will bring health to your body, nourishment to your bones. Oh, I believe you fear the Lord. I believe from today on you shall repent. You shall not live in sin, and you shall obey the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord is like a medicine. Proverbs chapter 4, 20 to 22. My son, give attention to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart, for they are life to those who find them and health to all their flesh. We read the Bible together now. We listen to the word of God. Put in your heart, in your eyes. Don't let them depart from your life. And the words of God are health to you, heal you in the name of Jesus Christ. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. Jesus Himself bore our sins in His own body on the tree, and that having died to sin, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes you were healed. I believe Jesus already healed you 2,000 years ago. You need to believe, and you need to receive that healing. I don't care what sickness you have. Even though the medical report say no hope, but in God we have hope. Dear Heavenly Father, it is your will that your children are healthy, strong, and have godly offspring. You promise that you will take away from us all sickness and will afflict us with none of the terrible diseases. We will do our best to diligently heed your voice and read your word and do what is right in your sight and give ear to your commandments and keep all your statutes. You promise us that you will put none of the diseases on us. We humble ourselves and pray to you and seek your face and turn from our wicked ways. Lord, you promised that you would hear from heaven and would forgive our sin and heal our land. I shall not die, but live and declare the works of my Lord. We will not forget your teaching, but keep your commands in our heart, for they will prolong our life and many years, and your word brings health to our body and nourishment to our bones. Lord Jesus, thank you so much for taking sickness that have attacked us and will afflict us on your wounds. We believe and declare that by your stripes we are healed. Lord, you promise in the book of Mark chapter 11, 23 to 24. For as surely I say to you, whoever say to this mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he say will be done, he will have whatever he says. Therefore I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them. Father, we together right now believe in your promise. We declare and command that sicknesses and disease that have attacked my brother and sister who are listening and watching this program must be healed, must go away by the stripes of Jesus Christ. You open the floodgate of heaven and pour the blessing of good health, prosperity, and abundance into their life. I command in the name of Jesus that this mountain of sickness have to leave their body right now. You are healed by the stripe of Jesus Christ. You are set free from the curses of the law. And the blessing, the favor, the goodness of the Lord shall be upon you. We believe that you are healed. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Why don't you pray with me? Follow my prayer. Father in heaven, I admit, Lord, that I am a sinner. I repent of my sin. Jesus is my Lord and my Savior. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Save me from sin, from curses, and from sickness and disease. Bless me, Lord Jesus. From today on, I will follow you and serve you. Thank you, Lord. In your name, Jesus, I pray. Amen. Congratulations. I believe healing is on the way, and you shall get better and get healed. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for coming to this time of praying together. And we believe in the promises of God. Amen.